I try and stay away from doing too many weeding videos on this channel. There's only so many ways that we can cover it. But the other day I was reading a blog and there was a single sentence that I had no idea could completely change my approach and attitude to weeding. And that is what this video is about. Well, actually, there were two things that stood out to me on the blog, and I'll come onto the weeding attitude later, because the first thing spoke about the law of return. The law of return is in nature, when something is taken from a soil ecosystem, it's got to be returned in order for it to maintain its balance and health. So take this hop, for example. Over spring and summer, the roots are drawing up nutrients from the ground. And then in autumn, the leaves fall back down, returning the nutrients to the soil, break down over winter, ready to start the cycle again in spring. It's the exact same story for this pear tree. Its leaves, which will fall onto the ground over autumn, will break down and provide those nutrients to help it again next year. However, we need to remember that most of the mass of this tree is water and carbon, and all of that carbon comes from the air through photosynthesis, gets turned into glucose to help the tree's growth and create things like cellulose, which is the most abundant organic polymer on this planet. Another example is when we harvest potatoes, the dry weight of the tubers, around 70% starch, and that comes from sugars created from photosynthesis. Basically, what I'm saying is that the majority of a plant's mass actually comes from the air and not from the soil. It's a tiny percentage of mass that comes from the soil, but it's a really important percentage because that's the nutrients. An example of this is, like humans, all plants need calcium, but calcium doesn't come from the air, it comes from the ground. So it's the nutritional needs of the plants that we need to consider with the law of return, because when we harvest something and we take it to the kitchen and eat it, even if we chop and drop all the crop residues, etc., there is a loss of nutrients from the soil. And that's why we add compost to help balance that out. And this is where a garden differs from nature. So take this tree, for example. The leaves, when they break down, they create a complete nutrient cycle. But in a garden, when we harvest crops, we're also harvesting the nutrients and taking them away. And this is where weeds come into the picture. I'm not here to debate about what a weed is. I think we can all agree that dandelions, thistles, and also nettles in our raised beds and pots are not welcome, at least for the long run. But we have to understand that weeds are nature's way of rebalancing soil health. Things like dandelions here and thistles send down deep roots to mine nutrients from below and then bring them up into their leaves. And when these plants break down, they're bringing and effectively leaving those nutrients in the topsoil. And also, when we weed a bed, or this is a tile where I'm going to grow just some ornamentals, what you're also doing is affecting the law of return, because weeds are full of nutrients and you're picking them off and you're carting them away. So in a second, I'll explain about why whenever you're weeding a section, you want to return those exact weeds to the spot that they were growing. But firstly, I want to share the main part of that blog article that honestly, it just made me think, wow, I'm never gonna look at weeding the same again. I'm paraphrasing what I read on this blog post, but it was along the lines of not seeing weeding as a chore, but actually as nutrient harvesting. And I thought, this is fantastic. I can actually trick my brain into finding a higher purpose to weeding than then clearing a bit of ground. It can actually be a harvest that's going to help me grow better crops. Let's unpack this a bit further. So firstly, let's say this bed had a load of dandelions. If we take and remove those dandelions but actually replace it with compost, we could actually be creating a nutrient imbalance, because dandelions are known to be an indicator of poor calcium, and so they're bringing calcium from further down up to the top. So if we actually chop and drop the dandelions on the surface, we're helping to rebalance those natural calcium levels. Now, if you don't fancy doing chop and drop, or you want to keep your beds nice and clean, I totally understand that. Whatever the weed is growing, whether it's like a load of nettles or thistles or dandelions, you can actually get them from elsewhere, for example, in the hedgerows or in your lawn, and create a weed soak from those, and then use that as a liquid feed to put back onto the soil. So you are actually returning those nutrients that are needed. For those of you in more suburban and rural areas, you can look at things like hedgerows as a great place to harvest nutrients to help enrich your garden and also your compost. This is Dock here, for example, and Dock is really high in potassium. So I can make a potassium plant feed using these leaves. It's not a weed, it's a fantastic plant to help me grow better food. It's really important to know that one of the main purposes of compost isn't just to add nutrients back into the soil, but also to create a carbon-rich environment to promote the microbes to actually make those nutrients plant available. So if you incorporate techniques such as no-dig alongside harvesting nutrients, aka weeding, and bringing weeds from external sources into your garden, you can help balance out that law of return and have a thriving garden. In your garden beds, you may come across bits of grass growing, which in that case are a weed, but grass is so abundant, it's free, and it is one of, if not the most valuable free resource for your garden. This video right here is going to show you how to best utilize grass in so many different ways to get you growing better and more nutritious crops from your vegetable garden.